Mohanjeet Singh, IAS Principal Secretary, Industries, Government of Delhi, to address the gathering.
Excellencies, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, let me at the outset thank the organizers on behalf of Honorable Minister of Industries, Government of Delhi, for inviting us in this event in this beautiful city. A city with the ultra-modern architecture and infrastructure, with a lively and vibrant lifestyle. Burj Khalifa, I believe, more than 800 meters tall tower, dominate the skyscrapers filled skyline. And the city has a beauty that one can escape to sea, sand, scenic sunsets with lush green oases, bustling shopping malls. It is a diverse destination, I would say. India and UAE, they enjoy strong bonds of friendship based on age-old cultural, religious, and economic ties. And one of the areas and highlights of India-UAE joint cooperation is in skill development and participation in projects in manufacturing industrial corridors and Startup India programs. Delhi government is committed to promote high technology, non-polluting, clean, and skilled industries in Delhi, with world-class infrastructure, facilitating business through procedural simplification and e-governance measures. Now, before coming for this event, I was studying a paper on SMEs in Dubai, in UAE. Now, the parameters under which they scale their SMEs are the degree of international orientation, prevalence of innovation, level of IT adoption, degree of human capital development, degree of corporate governance, and level of access to finance and global competitiveness. Now, yesterday, we heard an honorable speaker saying about rules and regulations and the procedural simplification. How do we gain the confidence and how do we instill confidence in the investor that he should come and invest in India? The other word used was engagement, how to engage these investors, how to build their confidence to come. Now, I can say on this forum that Government of Delhi is committed for this friendly environment. A number of initiatives have been taken. We have talked about ease of India doing business. We have talked about India jumping at least 30 points above. Now it is 100, and somebody said, why not amongst the first 10? So I can assure you that that time is also going to come. Then we'll be in the top countries in ease of doing business. Now, yesterday, Honorable Minister talked about the strengths of Delhi in the form of infrastructure, in the form of wide roads, in the form of airports, transport, good power situation. It's a global metropolis. Delhi has 100% telecom penetration, and it is home to several government offices. Now, states may say that the state is only 200 kilometers from Delhi, or 150 kilometers or 100 kilometers from Delhi, but we are Delhi ourselves. There are a lot of government offices, there are a lot of institutions, research institutions, medical institutions, educational institutions, which are available in Delhi. We have the largest pool of skilled manpower, be it in IT, engineering, medicine, law, accounting, consultancy, IT, ITES, research and development, biotechnology, nanotechnology, you name any. And Delhi government is also in the process of setting up an incubation center. And DSI IADC is volunteered to provide space and to provide all logistics support for this endeavor. Both Delhi and Dubai government, they are committed to enhancing the contribution and performance of SME sector to make this business comparable to other developed world economies. And as far as Dubai is concerned, I think this is the only, UAE is the only country where a lot of support is provided to startups, despite being a strong competition from other European states, countries like New Zealand, Singapore, and Norway. I think Dubai is the country. Yesterday we heard somebody talking about starting an industry with three people, and now he said that there are 5,000 people who are working in the industry. You have a dream and you can fulfill in this country. Even countries like Germany and Japan, purported to be the best in the world for entrepreneurs, would find it hard to match the extraordinary mix of dynamism, growth, technology, strategic location, and the government incentives that Emirates have to offer. As UAE is a world-renowned technology hub, it is number one for environment innovation, exceptional incentives for startups, global connections, infrastructure is excellent, safety and lifestyle, and low taxes for business. It's a magic mix. I will utilize this forum to make a fervent appeal to the entrepreneurs, developers, and businessmen in the government of, and the government of Dubai. To come to Delhi, we welcome you and will provide all logistics supports in the upcoming projects or collaborate in the existing ones. These investment opportunities will definitely promote strategic partnership between the two governments and the entrepreneurs from either side. Now we have an audiovisual presentation and we will play it, and we will be specifically focusing on three upcoming projects, that is in Rani Kheda and in Kanjavala and Baprola. So I'll now request to kindly play the presentation. Jai Hind.
India is known the world over not just as the sixth largest economy, but also as a nation known for its rich culture and heritage. And Delhi, being the capital of the country, epitomizes this in every spirit. Delhi has been home to history, but the story has moved beyond the pages of history. Today, Delhi is growing at a rapid pace, creating new growth stories, limitless opportunities every day. Spread over 1,483 square kilometers area, the state has been home to around 18.41 million people. It has grown at an unprecedented rate with a decadal growth percentage of 21% and an urbanization rate of 98%. Infrastructure development in Delhi has always been the focus of successive state and central governments. Superior connectivity to other parts of the country and the presence of strong social infrastructure has helped Delhi attract talent from across the country, which has subsequently helped it position itself as a key investment destination. Presence of Delhi Metro, one of the largest metro network in India and the fourth largest network in the world, well-connected national highways and road network, both inter and intra-city, aptly showcases the city's well-established infrastructure. Delhi is known to be the largest aviation hub in India and South Asia, having an airport spread over an area of approximately 5,100 acres and business passenger traffic of 57.7 million in 2017. North and West Delhi are well connected with the rest of North India through a robust railway network. Delhi is the educational hub of the country with 4 central universities, 5 state universities, and 13 deemed universities. There have been massive improvements in the education sector in Delhi. The state has been focusing primarily on infrastructure development of government schools, flexible admission norms, initiation of parent-teacher meetings, loans to students applying for higher education to create a congenial environment for students and teachers. The government of NCT of Delhi has been providing accessible and quality healthcare services through its flagship neighborhood Mohalla clinics. These healthcare centers provide for basic medical care for common illnesses, lab investigations, and access to essential drugs free of cost to patients. The government has also brought about a revolutionary change in governance with the launch of the doorstep delivery of public services, including driving license and marriage registration certificate at a very nominal charge. But what makes Delhi the preferred investment destination? Competent and diverse talent pool, investor-friendly policies of the government, world-class infrastructure and institutions, large consumer market, educational hub of India. Per capita income at current prices stands at $4,419.85, which is almost three times the national average. Largest metro rail network in India, fourth largest in the world. Road network of over 33,000 kilometers. Over 200 railway stations link Delhi with neighboring regions. One of the busiest airports in the world, with traffic of 57.7 million business passengers in 2017. Easy access to power and water supply at lowest tariffs compared to other states. Significant growth across IT, telecom, hotel, banking, media and tourism sectors. The city's continuous focus on ensuring improvements in every sector, be it health, education or business, and ensuring ease of business procedures has made it an investor's ideal destination for business. According to a survey conducted by economic think tank, National Council of Applied Economic Research, NCAER, Delhi topped among 21 states and one union territory to emerge as the best investment destination. Setting up a business has been made easy in Delhi, with the central and state governments undertaking various reforms related to making the state business-friendly. Initiatives undertaken include online registration under Delhi Shops and Establishment Act and Udyog Aadhaar Number under MSMED Act 2006. GST registration within 3 days with provision for deemed approval. Online appointment for property registration. Reduction in application process for electricity connections and faster connections within 15 days through online submission. Single window portal for obtaining approval on building plans. Online payment of taxes, registration under GST, and enforcement of contracts. Power tariffs in Delhi have been reduced considerably in comparison to other states. The state promises its inhabitants uninterrupted power services and proposes the use of solar energy to generate power. The new Master Plan of Delhi, MPD 2021, prepared by Delhi Development Authority, DDA, has made way for spatial planning and policy making in the prime city. The new Master Plan and Land Pooling Policy Plan has created more land banks to decongest Delhi and introduce new investment opportunities. As per the Master Plan 2021, the new industrial activity in Delhi has been restricted to high-tech areas such as computer hardware and software industry and industries doing system integration with computer hardware and software. The term high-tech area is used for the purpose of referring to the nature of the industry rather than expanding the scope of terms industry or manufacturing process by deeming fiction. Development of new industrial areas in greenfield areas of NCT of Delhi should be planned for the purpose of relocation of existing industries and for the development of a limited type of new industries, greenfield sites for high-tech industries. Delhi's people-friendly industrial policy further makes it easy doing business within the state. Through the implementation of this policy, the state intends to promote non-polluting and clean industries, promote high technology and skilled industries in Delhi, to keep in-migration of unskilled labor to minimum, develop world-class infrastructure within planned industrial estates and regularized industrial clusters, promote cluster approach and walk-to-work concepts wherever possible, facilitate business through procedural simplifications and e-governance measures, promote transparent and business-friendly environment. The nature and profile of industries, particularly SMEs in Delhi, have evolved over a period of years. The focus today has shifted from engineering goods, home appliances, electronics, packaging, to knowledge-based industries, involving more of knowledge, investment, and human capital. The list of industries being promoted heavily by the state includes software, IT services, ITES, media, biotechnology, R&D design, business services, and educational services. Delhi has also opened its arms to welcome budding entrepreneurs to start up within the state. It is the mission of the GNCT of Delhi to make the state one among the top 10 startup destinations in the world. The state aims to facilitate and nurture growth of at least 5,000 new startups, create 2.5 lakh direct and 7.5 lakh indirect new employment opportunities, and establish world-class incubation centers and tinkering labs at schools and colleges to rev up the startup culture. One of the recent breakthrough developments in the landscape of Delhi is the multi-level, high-tech and ready-to-use manufacturing hub for SMEs at Rani Kheda Mundka. The industrial park at Rani Kheda Mundka would be catering to specific needs of IT, ITES industry and research, and will have 10 to 12 clusters of different industries. Well connected through highways and metro, this industrial paradise is all set to revolutionize the industrial landscape of Delhi. Valued at a tentative cost of rupees 5,000 crores approximately. This manufacturing hub will house extremely modern architecture, comprising 19 industrial buildings, 6 warehouse buildings, commercial properties, and miscellaneous provisions like admin building, parking, roads, ESS, and STBs. All in all, it is poised to be a clean, green industrial hub, having 70% open area, of which 40% of the area would be green. Another significant project that is shaping up in Delhi is a high-tech, modern, knowledge-based industrial park at Baparola. This project will boost the industrial policy of GNCTD with a walk-to-work concept. This aesthetically designed industrial park, valued at a tentative cost of rupees 1,510 crores approximately, will be functionally efficient and green with Griha compliancy. It will house 10 industrial buildings, commercial properties, and provide for miscellaneous provisions like hospital, ITI, fuel station, residential, parking, roads, ESS, and STPs. Another project that requires mention is the Clean Green Integrated Industrial Township at Kanjhavla. This industrial project is located close to Narela. This site is well connected through highways and metro. India's growth story is all set to change with Delhi spearheading from the front, because at the heart of Delhi's development story lies the efforts of the state's government.
May I now request Mr. Vaibhav Chaudhary, Director and Head Government Advisor, to come forward and address the gathering.
Hello everyone, and very good afternoon. I'm going to take a very small time of yours. We're going to specifically focus on the three opportunities which we just highlighted at the end of the AV. Before we deep dive into these three opportunities, I would like to take a step back and possibly mention some of the key aspects which we tried showcasing as part of the AV film we just played. What we need to understand is that Delhi as a state had problems with regards to offering large industrial parks for our SMEs, for occupiers to come in and start their, you know, entrepreneurial exercise in the state. With the new land pooling policy, a lot of land has been unlocked and DSIIDC has been given the command to take over and offer these land parcels for entrepreneurs to come in and restart investment into Delhi. So, not taking much of your time, I would like to go forward on this. As you can see on the slide, this shows the map of Delhi where we are highlighting the different locations where our current and upcoming industrial parks are situated. The first blue bullet which you see is actually the industrial park of Baparola. The fifth is the multi-level manufacturing hub at Rani Kheda Mundka. And third is the industrial township at Kanjavla. These are the three brand new opportunities which are available for occupiers, infrastructure developers, industrial park developers to come in and form partnerships and look at Delhi as an investment opportunity because of its unique positioning today. Industrial park number two and number four are already operational industrial parks where we already have more than 16,000 industrial units which are currently operational. We do have few more pockets left as part of the two industrial parks which are currently operational, but we're largely focusing on Baparola, Rani Kheda, and Kanjavla at this point in time. So to get into specifics, Baparola is a 83-acre land parcel and has been earmarked to be developed as a knowledge-based industrial park. Now, what it entirely means is that we are going to be focusing on human capital development by having industries such as IT, ITS, media, research and development, gems and jewelry, and business services. Not only would it have industrial units on offer, we would also be looking at about 88,000 square meter of residential space. Now, what we need to understand is that all the three opportunities which are currently being developed, they are being developed as integrated township developments to promote walk-to-work culture. We are offering residential spaces. They will all have their own unique aspects in terms of having their own police stations, their own fire brigade stations. They will have educational institutes, and they will also have training institutes as part of the industrial township projects. The second project that I would like to mention is the Rani Kheda Mundka project. This is a large opportunity of about 147 acres. We're looking at a direct and indirect employment of approximately 7.5 lakh personnel at this particular location. The phase one itself will constitute of about 7 lakh square meter of industrial space. Now, if I was to just take a step back and, you know, highlight what that opportunity means in itself, this would probably be the biggest offering of Delhi of allowing entrepreneurs to come into Delhi and look at Delhi from an investment perspective versus having to go to any other state nearby Delhi. As a few minutes back, sir has already mentioned, every state will say we are 100 kilometers, 200 kilometers away from Delhi. We are Delhi, and this opportunity is in the heart of Delhi. We're not talking of a location which is far and beyond at the peripheral locations of Delhi. We're talking about a location which is well connected by metro, which is well connected by existing roads, which is already well connected by the airport, has proximity to railway station, and is actually located at a very important junction of NH10, which goes towards Chandigarh, NH8, which goes towards Rajasthan, and NH48, which goes deeper into Haryana. So we are not away from Delhi, we are actually in the heart of Delhi. And this is an offering which we have at this point in time. The kind of industries we plan to cater from this particular location would include electronics component manufacturing, system design and testing, and biotechnology. Moving to the third offering, Kanjavla is actually a work in progress. This is going to be our third largest offering which we will have as part of the availability of industrial space that we would be showcasing in Delhi. While you know, this is yet to be master planned, the initial concept design and etc. have already taken place, but we want to actually invite large occupiers, developers to come in, partner with us for this particular opportunity. We are absolutely flexible on the kind of requirements that you may have, what you would want us to look at. We are keen of developing infrastructure in partnership with you and offer it at an international level. Thank you so much for your time.
Thank you, Mr. Chaudhary. May I now request Sri Arun Mishra, Executive Director, Delhi State Industrial Infrastructure Development Corp, to come forward.
Hello, everyone. It's good afternoon. I represent the Delhi State Industrial and Infrastructure Development Corporation, and that is a public sector undertaking under the state government of NCT of Delhi. And we have been mandated to develop these three key projects, which Vaibhav has just taken you through. All the three projects are at very advanced stages of planning and execution. The main purpose of us coming here is to spread awareness about these three key projects and invite the attention of the investors, the business and industry to get detailed further information, and then we can work together. The models are all open. We need about 5,000 crores in the first phase. That is about roughly $6 billion. So there is an interest, there is an opportunity for investors at three levels. One for the infrastructure developers, the financiers at the mega level. They can take up the entire project, or they can, we can break up the projects into different modules, and they can take up one as per their suiting their requirement. And they have, we have also have opportunities for large occupiers, small occupiers, even for micro units to take and book space in these industrial projects. That is our main purpose coming here, and spread awareness and generate interest. I think the launch time is near, so we must wind up. This is the last of the state government presentations. I, on behalf of Government of Delhi and DSIDC, thank the organizers, BLF, the United Arab Emirates Ministry of Economy, and the Indian Embassy and Consulate General at UAE to invite us and give us this opportunity. And thank you. Thank you, everyone.